One, Brandon Convery, welcome back to video number two of this Advanced Mentor program. And so I wanted to take the time to go over a little bit the topic about how leaders think, and especially this particular time in the season, because we're coming on the middle of October, and I think it's we're 1 month into this program. And I think it's really important that you really understand how leaders of this game and top leaders think that have a success and achieve success on a consistent basis. And really for this time of the year is talking about maybe doing a few things that will impact your game in little ways. And that's what this is all about, is doing little things exceptionally well, consistently over time, and hopefully reaching the goal that you want to attain. And so when we talk about how leaders think, there's a couple things, and I wanted to give five to you today for this video, and just focus on these five and really think about how this applies to you and how you can raise your game if you focus on these strategies or do some of these things that I ask you to do, how maybe it might impact or change your game. And I think it's important that number one, when we talk about being open, leaders are open, and especially this time of the season, I want to ask you, how many times have you had that dialogue with your coach where you said, hey coach, based on the last 6 months of the season, the first 6 weeks of the season, where am I at? What do you think I need to improve upon? What am I doing well? And where do you see me going based on what you see? And I think it's important that we have that open conversation, because the number one thing that comes from it shows you care. Because I will bet 98% of that team that you play on, if you look around the dressing room, 98% of them, maybe even more, don't have that open conversation with their coach where they just check in on a monthly basis where it's say, hey, coach, what do you think? What do I need to get better at? And by doing that one simple thing, it shows you care and goes a long way. And so I highly recommend over the next week that you make that commitment to sitting down for 2 to 5 minutes with your coach. It doesn't take long. I'm not asking you to have a 30-minute meeting with your parent, but I think it's important as a player. I think it's important that you do it as a player yourself. I think it's time for you, that all the players that are involved in my program, it's time to show a little bit more maturity and do it yourself and not rely on your parent to do it. So number two would be honest. And when I say honest, is being honest about your own self-evaluation. You know, back here we talked about getting an evaluation from your coach and some feedback, but being honest with yourself, where are you at right now based on where you thought you would be? And so are you doing the things like you're supposed to be doing over the weeks, and what's expected from your coach or even with this program? If you want to get high performance and play at higher levels, are you doing the little things consistently that are going to take you there? And I hope that you are. And if you aren't right now, if you be honest with yourself and say, hey, I need to be better, I need to be more consistent, I know that, I just need a little bit of help. Or so look for it, ask questions. That's why I have an open invite to you guys to text me anytime or email me with questions. If you phone, generally I get back to you pretty quickly. So having that honest conversation with yourself as to where you're at right now is definitely a big part of this season, because you don't want to get going through the whole season and then at the end of the year go, hey, whoop, what happened? And so I want to set yourself up for next season. The third thing is capable. Great players feel they're capable of achieving anything, and that they believe that they have the confidence to achieve anything or be put in a situation that they can have the ability to take care of or take on that responsibility at that time. And so we have to start thinking like leaders. We have to start behaving with our body language. When visually someone looks at us, someone says, hey, this kid's in it. This kid's, he wants to get better. This kid's serious. These are things that if when you have that self-belief where you feel you're capable of achieving or playing at higher levels or playing if you're going from a third line to first line, or if you're a defenseman playing on the fourth defense to the now on the power play, or if you're a goalie that's maybe been a backup and now you're in an opportunity to show what you have to feel like you're capable of taking on that position at that time. And so we have to get better at that in all areas moving forward. The fourth thing, deserving. Leaders expect success. They expect to do well. And so a part of this whole program, when we talk about how leaders think and how great players behave and what they do consistently, they expect to do well. And so I can remember, you know, when I played in my own days, I mean, I held myself to the highest standard. I wanted to be held accountable. Like, I expected, I was an offensive player. I wrote down before every game I played in my youth, every time I wrote down what goals and assists that I expected to get before the game, and after the game I filled it in what I actually got. And you can imagine what the end result was to that. I pretty much attained every goal I wanted to get consistently, give or take a little bit. But you know, if I wrote down I wanted to get 3 goals, I mean, my goal would be, let's get 4. These are things, and that's a mentality you want to get into, is that you want to push yourself to expect success and hold yourself to a higher standard. And that's what really, how great leaders and the leaders of the game, they expect to do well. And so I hopefully over time in this program is that you learn to get better at what you're doing and hold yourself to higher standards. And I think it's really important that you do the work and do the little things consistently. And I think you're going to find that you feel better about yourself at the end of the season. And number 5 would be persistent. You know, leaders, they stick with it. When they have something in mind, they stick with it and they do the necessary things. It's not work to them. It's just what's required. And we just do what we have to do to get it done. And so when we get in that mentality where we're persistent after what we're trying to achieve, we don't look at it as, oh, this is hard work, or I have to sit in the car and drive for 45 minutes to get to practice. And this is, they're excited about the opportunity. And so sticking with what you set out for, and that's why down here, that all relates to this. And I know we haven't talked about this much, but it comes down to is, what's your goal for this season? We're a month into this program and we really haven't focused too much on goal setting, because you should have a little bit of a background on that by now. But what is your ultimate goal by the end of February or March this year? And then you should work your way back. I think on a monthly basis, you should have 3 specific goals, and that should be your homework for this month. We got 2 weeks left of the month of October. What's 2 things that you'd like to achieve or do by the end of this month that's going to help you move forward? Now, one could be setting up a meeting with your coach. That's one goal. I don't know what the next goal is for you, but ultimately we have to start getting goal-oriented here. We don't have to have 10 goals for the season or 10 outcomes that we want to achieve. Let's take it week by week, month by month. I don't want you to get overwhelmed, go, oh my God, I got to do this, and if I don't do it, I'm not going to get that. If you work in small 2 to 3 specific goals per month, that's what I'd like you to do. Now, whether it's if you're pursuing to go to a prep school next year or get into the NCAA, anything like that, it could be academic as well as with sports, because they all go hand in hand. But I want you at the end of October, we're gonna start setting out for the month of November. What's 3 specific goals you'd like to achieve for that month? So we just stack on top of each other, and sooner or later, by the end of the season, we look back, go, hey, I accomplished this, 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 and this, and I feel better and come more confident about where I am as a player and what I've achieved, as opposed to going through the season and just reacting to other people's wants and other people's demands. Maybe you're not on a really good team this year, so you maybe need to change your expectations and not look at success in team wins, as opposed to how you handle your situation and how you can improve because of it. Because you're not always going to be stuck in that mode. Sometimes you're going to be on good teams where the game is a lot easier to play. Other times you're going to be on teams where, hey, we don't have that much talent, so we got to be a little bit smarter, work a little harder to find ways to have success. And so I'm more concerned with you as an individual, how to maximize what you have. And that's why when we talk about these 5 things here, thinking like leaders, whether it's being open and having that conversation with your coach, being honest with yourself capable, having that belief system internally, like you're ready and like you deserve and expect success. These are key points. And number five is that you're persistent with it. You stick with it, you get after it, maybe you get a little bumped, you get knocked off the horse, you're back at it again though. We don't get, you know, rocked. That's why we have a mentor, that's why you're involved with my program, to keep you focused on what you say you want to work towards. And the last is what you're working towards. I want to know what your goal is. And I think it's important that we start holding ourselves a little bit more accountable so we can push the bar a little bit more. Other than that, I look forward to talking to you guys soon. Have a great week.